into the start house. What enormous pressure for this man. Silver medalist at the Solomon Lake Plats in 1980. We'll never forget it. Led Stingemark, Ingemar Stenmark, after the first race. He took the silver medal up there. Then he went on to win three overall World Cup championships. A great ski racer. It's been a tough year for him, however. His decision, his self-announced decision to give up the World Cup tour after nearly a decade and really leading the U.S. Alpine ski team out of the doldrums to the very top of the heap, if you will. Here's his brother with the best time at the bottom. They have talked back and forth on the walkie-talkie. A lot of pressure on Phil, his wife Holly in Scottsdale, Arizona, with her parents awaiting the arrival of a child. And the snow was bad around Christmas time. Phil and Steve had to go back to get training runs in their home state of Washington. And here he is, his last Olympics ahead of him. His brother at the bottom of the hill is the leader. His best finish thus far was at Kitzbühel this year, a fourth place in the slalom. He disqualified twice. Here he is.
Okay, Frank, you know the one thing that Steve has told him at the bottom is plant that pole and make sure you ski well, particularly off the top. That's the key, I think. And he's all over the place at the top. You can see those hands getting back. He's going to have to get on them if he's going to make it down as it gets steeper. Oh, he's skiing a little bit better right now. Pressure's off him just a little bit because Steve's sitting down in first place.
Mayer's time on the right is running. That's his brother Steve. He has the best time up at the top. And Phil, a little slow as the course is starting to get a little chattery up on the top.
Okay, he was a little ragged at the top, but I think he's skiing a lot better right now. You can see him on his skis better down here. He's skiing an awful lot better. He's on his skis better down here.
The rhythm is there now.
The key is to keep planting that pole. Use those knees and ankles.
Running time on the right. His brother Steve Mayer's time will come up on the left. He is the leader.
He's going to have a pretty good time, Frank.
Fourth place. And could be third, depending upon Fromelt, a lifting sign, who it looked like missed the gate. Phil Mayer successfully down. He finished eighth at the giant slalom a few days ago, and I'm sure that he was disappointed with that finish. He'd like to come back here and add another Olympic medal to the silver that he already possesses from Lake Placid in 1980. And again, in his final season of competition, much on this young man's mind, but you can't take away what he has done for skiing in the United States.
Well, he was a little shaky at the top, Frank, but he was certainly on him at the bottom. He's in good position for the second run.
They're here by the thousands for Poyang
11.
Up at the top of the hill, Phil Mayer, his last Olympics. He was in third place after the first run. He was 0.7 seconds behind his twin brother. He's 4 minutes older. And nevertheless, this is his last opportunity for another medal. A silver medalist at Lake Placid behind the great Ingemar Stenmark. Three times the overall World Cup champion, the first American male to ever do that. The first American ever to win an overall competition. A great competitor, Bob. He's on the court.
Okay, Frank, he's got to really concentrate, ski technically well. He's a great athlete and a good competitor. Not very happy with the results this year. This would be a great way to end all the people who are saying he's finished.
Good rhythm on the top.
Oh, he got his hand behind a little bit. He's got to plant that pole every turn. Very quick down through here.
Running time is on the right. The best intermediate time, of course, is out of Bouvet, the Frenchman. That's on the left. And Phil Mayer has beaten that.
Okay, he's okay up through here. He's skiing very well. Got to make sure he's on every turn. Concentration is the key for him. He's got to be aggressive, though, too, and that's what makes it so hard on a steep hill. You can't get too defensive.
Years in training, 10 years on the World Cup circuit. This will be the final.
He's having a good run, Frank. He's going to be good down through here.
To take the lead is on the left from Bouvier, and he
okay, Frank.
Got first place. Phil Mayer into first place, and still to come his brother, Steve. Finished eighth in the giant slalom to Phil Mayer. Disappointed there, but he is in great position. Quickly, he grabs a walkie-talkie. He's going to talk to Steve Mayer, who will have one racer before he comes down, telling him about the gate, talking with Phil, Steve up at the top. There's Steve.
There's Steve getting the word.
Says.
Well, it takes a lot of pressure off Steve, I'll tell you that. Probably the only man who realistically has a chance for a gold medal is at the top, and it's his twin brother.
What a great pair the twins have been for American skiing over the past decade. This perhaps the final season for both of them. Phil is definite about it. Steve is not totally committed to leaving the circuit this year.
He got a little bit behind up there. He lost a little bit of time. Got a little bit of wide. He's got to get moving again.
Good
now he's starting
now.
To ski better. keep banging that pole on the ground, using those knees and ankles, getting in one turn, out of the other. That's his brother Phil's best time up at the top. No, he's behind the time of Phil Mayer, his brother up in the top.
Oh, and he's having all kinds of trouble.
Yeah, he was working the 67 hundredths of a lead.
He just got up behind a little bit in that quick little section through there, Frank. Cost him a lot of time. Probably cost him a goal. He might still be able to get in there for a medal, though.
Running time.
Oh, he's got his hand caught behind his back.
Time to beat to take the lead from his brother Phil on the left.
Oh, what a run he had.
They are 1-2.
Unbelievable.
Had a great recovery up at the top, Bob. Got it back on it. Phil Mayer's in first place, and Steve Mayer is in second place.
Frank, that's an unbelievable miracle because, really, Steve was all over the mountain. He was all over the place. I can't believe he kept his skis going down the mountain. Anybody but such a great athlete would have been everywhere. Frank, let's take a look at one of the spots where he had a lot of trouble. There were many along the way, but I think this was one of the most difficult. Came around this turn in really good shape. All of a sudden, right here, though, leaned on his inside ski. It railed on him. He almost fell down. Great recovery. Sat back on his skis. Almost finished the next gate. Still kept coming. Got around it. Lost all kinds of time. By that maneuver, I really think he probably saved himself a medal. On the other hand, he might have lost the gold to Phil.